In Lebanon, Syrian refugees are scattered around the country. The largest concentration lives just a 15-minute drive from the Syrian border, in tents in camps in the Bekaa Valley. Other refugees find shelter in dilapidated buildings like this one in the capital, Beirut. Still, others reside in cordoned-off areas within cities that have become refugee ghettos. That's where I met the woman who asked us to call her Suha, for her protection. She left the besieged city of Homs, Syria, 3.5 years ago, fleeing a civil war she describes as a fire.
The war began suddenly, burned everything.
She says her family didn't take sides, but that didn't protect them from soldiers loyal to Syrian President Bashar al-Assad.
My brother was killed.
What happened?
They shot him in the back, and he died.
Suha came to suspect her own husband was responsible for her brother's death.
I discovered he is a double agent.
So he was working for the regime.
After a long time, I discovered that.
Confused and fearing for her life, Suha left her husband and escaped to Lebanon by paying a smuggler to drive her and her two children across the border. She lives on the fifth floor of this rundown building with her 9-year-old son, Rad, and daughter, Rachad, who's 4. Electricity is on only a few hours a day, so she has no refrigerator. Her biggest worry is her children's safety.
This is miserable for the kids. When they know the gun everywhere.
You want your children to grow up in peace.
Yes, that's what I want.
Suha is going to get her wish. A few months ago, an Italian Christian charity project called Humanitarian Corridor selected her family to resettle in Italy. The same people helped the Vatican choose 3 Syrian families to fly with Pope Francis from Greece to Italy in April. Giancarlo Pensa is International Relations Director of the participating charity Comunità di Sant'Egidio.
The Pope, he called us to choose the people, 12 people. It's a gesture in order to show that what he was doing is easy, is reasonable, and is right.
Humanitarian Corridor intends to transport 600 Syrian and Iraqi refugees from Lebanon to Italy during the next 2 years. The charity project screens the candidates, obtains hard-to-get humanitarian visas, and arranges their flights. Simone Scotta is a field officer for the NGO Mediterranean Hope. He helps run the project and initially interviewed Suha, who is on the list for the next airlift.
This is the list.
Yeah, this is the list of 101 people that will leave in 2 days.
101 people.
101, yeah.
So out of over 1 million refugees here in Lebanon, it's been narrowed down to 101.
Only 101 we can move. So yeah, these are the luckiest, maybe.
The luckiest met certain criteria. They were considered especially vulnerable, but also likely to assimilate in Italian society. Suha was a veterinarian back in Syria.
She always worked in her life, and we are sure that she will find her way in Italy.
Something are unknown to me, where I sleeping, the house, the area, the neighbors, but I think everything will be okay.
Have you packed your bags already?
Yes. Yes.
Suha is giving away the few possessions she has to her fellow refugees.
One jacket for Ragad, one jacket for Ragad.
Most of what her family is taking fits in one suitcase.
One change of clothes for yourself.
Yes.
And one change of clothes for each of your kids.
Yes.
That's it.
Yes.
That's 3 lives inside of one suitcase.
Yes.
Mixed with the excitement is sadness. Suha has friends who desperately want a new start too, like Raisa, who is also from Homs. Raisa lost everything she owned in Syria and bears the scars of war. She was shot in the leg by a sniper. Not among the chosen, she's staying behind in Lebanon.
We know many families, you just cannot help everybody, so you need to choose, yeah.
What's that like, to say no?
Most of them, they understand, because we explain to them in a very clear way, we have a tiny number and there are people that deserve more help than you. Many of them understand, some other times people get pissed.
Tensions are high among refugees and within Lebanese society. Nora Jumblatt, a businesswoman and philanthropist in Beirut, says Lebanon has a long history of helping refugees in the region, but the welcome mat has worn thin.
We have to remember that we have Palestinian refugees, and we also have had an influx of Iraqi refugees at one point. It is a very difficult situation, and it's a very precarious situation because the strain on the infrastructure, on water, on electricity, on jobs, is huge.
Syrian refugees are not officially allowed to work in Lebanon, but many do, mainly in construction and the service sector. This Lebanese jewelry store owner complains Syrian refugees are hurting an already fragile economy.
They're impacting our medical care and taking the aid that's meant for the poor people of our country. They're taking many things from electricity to gas expenses and taking it for a lesser price.
Refugees who relied on their savings to survive have found that after 5 years of war, their money is running out. And Syrian currency is worth much less than it used to be.
This one, it's about $20 before the war. It's $20. Now it's $2.
Omar's money exchange store is on one of Beirut's busiest shopping streets.
If you walk here, each 2 meters, 3 meters, there's a little boy or a little girl and her mother.
So little kids begging in the street.
Yeah, begging.
This boy was begging for money to buy gum to resell on the street. He doesn't go to school. Getting Syrian refugee children into school is one goal of Nour Jumblatt's foundation, called Kayani. It has built private schools that can accommodate 2,500 kids, but that's a fraction of the need.
Why aren't these Syrian children going to Lebanese public schools?
Because of lack of space. We have about 155,000 refugee children going to the Lebanese public school. However, there are about 350,000 that are still in need.
350,000 Syrian refugees,
yes,
who aren't,
yes,
getting education.
Yes, who are not getting. And this is, of course, a very dangerous affair because this is the future of Syria. These children should go back to build Syria.
And that's what the Lebanese are hoping for, the war to end and the Syrians to return home. Suha wants that too. But for now, thanks to the charity project, she's leaving with her children to start a new life in Italy today.
Are the kids excited, ready to go?
More than me.
They take some last minute photos and say their goodbyes. When the family arrives at the first meeting point, they meet other refugee families on the airlift. Suitcases labeled, they board the bus for Beirut. Out the window, the Mediterranean Sea. Suha was once desperate enough to consider paying a smuggler to take them to Europe by boat. But her son Rod, who'd seen stories on TV about children drowning, said no. And Suha agreed. They arrive in Beirut, where they meet still more refugees from Syria, families bound for different cities around Italy. And then another bus ride to the airport to catch their 4 a.m. flight. Italia! 2 weeks later, I meet up with Suha in the riverside town of 10,000 people in northern Italy, where she and her children now live. For now, her family is sharing a one-bedroom apartment with an elderly Syrian woman who left Lebanon on the same Christian charity flight.
I sleep here, and the old woman with me here.
This is my kitchen. Refrigerator.
You have a refrigerator.
Yeah.
You got a stove, you got an oven. That's important.
There's a big park behind their apartment where the children can play. They start school next week.
I want to have time to learn and to work.
Under Italian law, it will be a few months before Suha is eligible to work. She's hoping to resume work as a veterinarian. In the meantime, the charity Mediterranean Hope is paying the rent and will give Suha's family $780 a month for at least the next 6 months. She says she would like to return to Syria someday.
To find a solution in Syria, I think it's far away. The most important thing is safeness. That's what I feel. Everything else will come.
From civil war in Syria, to a refugee camp in Lebanon, to a new beginning in Italy.
I hope good things will happen. I am hopeful, really.